Hi, I'm Brad Shores, and this is Tropical Shores Steel Drum Lessons. And today's lesson is going to be on El Cumbanchero. El Cumbanchero is a very fast Mexican samba, obviously, and the lesson for today is two things on this song. Not so much improv, but the lesson would be learning to play double stops. Right at the beginning, you can see on this song that there are double stops, an F and A, and then F and B flat, F, B natural, and that, I would just keep my left hand on the F and move my right hand to the various different notes. Here it is again. So if that's your first time playing double stops, it could be a little challenging. The next lesson on this song is there's a couple of runs here, and what I mean by runs is measure, I think it's maybe like 13, what is that? 24 has this lick in it. Here it is again. First, you have to learn what those notes are and how that run goes, but you have to learn to teach your muscles how that's going to play every time. In fact, before I filmed this video, I ran through that a couple times just to make sure I was up to snuff on it. Like, I don't want to play this way. That doesn't work with my hands. That's crazy. So I figured out what was the best way for my hands to do that. I used a lot of right hands over here because it's so fast that my left hand just couldn't cross that fast. So you do what's right for you, but that's an encouragement. Don't feel like you have to play right, left all the time. And so make sure that it's right for you. And so on this lesson, we're going to talk about motor memory and double stops. And here's the song. I'll play a little bit of it. We'll talk some more. Chromatic means it hits every note on the piano right there, just by half steps. That's a challenge too, because then you have to not only play that lick, but you have to continue with the song. So there's a couple challenges in this song. I also changed the rhythm on this on one of my CDs, and so it's not quite so straight like I might do. That's just personal taste. It adds interest. It adds rhythmic interest. That's sort of a way of improv, just to change. I also can put D and F together. Play the higher D that I'm playing on the music and put a low F. It sounds great. And then play the F with an A. And when you add a note, it almost adds a player. It almost seems like you have another player with you. So it fattens up your sound a little bit if you're playing by yourself. Well, that's it for this time. I'd like you to like the video. Put comments or questions on what you would like to see on the next video. Subscribe to the channel. For all your music needs for steel drum, I want you to go to tropicalshores.net. Go to panland.name.com to join that. Thanks for watching.